Morning. We're about to play the Pokemon Scarlet DLC. Very exciting. What a time to be alive. Of course, Pokemon Sword and Shield had DLC before this. And previous games had the third version, your Pokemon Blue or Yellow in the West, your Pokemon Crystal, your Pokemon Emerald, your Pokemon Platinum, your Pokemon Black 2 and White 2, a little bit different. Hi, Mr. Jack. All right then. Head to the entrance hall. Remember which button is your map. That one. I'm actually pretty close. Let's do it the old-fashioned way. Just a Diglett, yeah. That's not just any Diglett. That's the Diglett. The diggity dog. As maybe you can see, dressed in my yukata for summer festivals. Hopefully, I'll have a matching outfit in game very soon. Oh, that's a combi. I thought that dude's hat was just going crazy. Oh, what? I can't climb walls in the city? Disappointing. Disappointed! Wherefore art thou? Entrance wall up there. Up here. Up here. And that way. Obviously, I've been playing a bit of this game. I did finish the Pokédex. I've done some shiny hunts, I've done some raids. I didn't do much, battling. I've never been that guy when it comes to Pokémon, not really. Guess I'm talking to this lady right here. Oh, very cool. Call me Miss Briar. Blueberry Academy. In the Unova region. Let's go. Let's go. Nice, don't have to talk to my mum. Let's go. A disc Pokemon. I thought they would be cool new NPCs, but it's just some generic students. Hello, Dragonite. Oh, it's... The Dragonite's under me. Oh, trust me, there was a cool loading screen of an airplane. And a Dragonite flew past the airplane. Looks very cute. My Suitown. Wow. So, this kind of rural mountainous Japan is exactly where I live. This is what the bus stops look like. That's what the rice fields look like. Very cool. Oh, look, a comfy. Ah, okay, so let's see what kind of level we're dealing with in the DLC. 57, okay. Oh god, I'm about to get wrecked by literally the first Pokemon I see. Okay, got away safely. Don't think I want agility. Uproar. No. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna evolve. Ooh, Spathra has a nice shiny. There we go, 55, perfect. Yeah, fine, whatever. For a single player campaign, you just need attacks that do damage. You know, I know this part is not very exciting, so I need to get on with it. Wait a minute. Attack. 190. Okay, yeah, definitely want physical attack. Probably not gonna bother with that one. Crunch. 60 but can flinch. 80 but lowers defense. I know competitively the flinch is more valuable. But I'm not that guy, brother. That different from a regular one, but the pink claws are pretty cool. What's that over there? Oh, it's just a rock. Is it worth keeping two dragon moves? I'm basically never going to use takedown, am I? Mega kick, that sounds good. 120, only 75 though. I'm basically never going to use that. Wide guard. Nah. Throat chop. Heck yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna mostly be going first. Oh, there we go, perfect. Brave Bird, hell yeah. Damages the user quite a lot. Doesn't actually know any fighting type moves. Low kick. That's heavier the target, alright. Where's one with a more flat damage? Break. That's it. You cannot learn. Outrageous. Unfair. Like in the music. Reversal. Just give me a normal fighting type move, please. No special, I need physical attack. Ah, close combat, that'll do. Right, yeah, it's literally just never worth having moves that do less than 100%. You know what I'm saying? Right, and do I have any false swipes? No, they probably need to make one at the Pokemon Center, don't I? Anyway, let us begin. Spinarak, hello. Wow, rude. Extremely rude. There we go, my first Kitakami Pokemon. Hello, Pachina. Oh, don't start that one. Cheeky devil. Anyway, so far I've made like 2 meters of progress in this DLC. It bears its large fangs and barks vigorously. Oh, look at them fangs. The little Groudon just came out of the rice field. Very accurate. So this is summer, with all the rice being that green. The rice is being harvested as we speak here in Nagano. And it means when you go to the rice fields, you can smell the rice. It smells like a cooked rice product. It's actually a really nice smell. It makes me very hungry. Whoopa. I'm Whoopaloopa. I'm from space. Oh, he's still asleep. Oops. Guess Bathory, you're up. Toxic, wow. The Pokemon around here mean business. Ah, nice. Under the water. No, didn't mean to use it on the spinner rack. Use it on my Pokemon. I mean, I guess they're all my Pokemon. Sorry, spinner rack. But you know you're going in a box pretty soon. It's mugging me off. Let's fight this thing. So Waddle, come back here. Ooh, endure. Oh, no, I wasn't going to knock it out anyway. Flail. Nice. Get in a ball. Get in a ball. You mug. Oh, I should go catch that Crawdon. Trying to mimic the clothes its mama first dressed it in. Sup, nerd? Crab hammer. Ooh. Ooh. Very nice, very nice. That's right, Corphish. Crawdon is the evolution. Do you like not want to fight or what? Yanma, let's go. Oh, I guess they're like working on the farms. They're not actually here for battling. Interesting. Does that apply to all of them? Okay, now that one wants a fight. Opportunist is nice. Ooh. That's when I'm playing no games. Whoa. Alright, I'm a psychic, yeah. That actually tracks. And Yanma's kind of a beast. Whoa. A little annoyed I haven't seen another cutie fly since that one that I had to run away from. Okay, they're there. Oh no, that's Swaddles. That's Vulpix over yonder. Carmine. Excuse me. Okay. Okay, we'll see about that, my friend. Yes, I know about type matchups. I've been playing Pokemon for nigh on 30 years. Thanks, I'll have an attack boost. Don't mind if I do. Oh, nice. Ghost and grass. Probably best off sticking with for the time being. Hey, look at that little matcha guy. Okay, rude. Ooh, cheeky. Vulpix, nice. Let me show you how we do it in Paldea. I am Gotham's reckoning. Indeed, I did go and beat your sis. I like her, she's funny. Look at that rage. To become one of your little grunts. I just wrecked you. Caretaker. I like this little Pokemon Center tent. Oh, the nurse is even different. She looks cool. False swipe, there we go. There we go. That'll be good for the old catching. I suspect I'll be doing a lot of here. She's just on her phone. Nice. Nice little K truck. I've ridden in many of these, and they are always exclusively driven by maniacs. Oh, did I just steal from someone's farm, essentially? There's the old rice fields, looking very nice. They are very well observed. Japanese houses all have these sort of outer propane tanks, especially like a super rural farmhouse like this. You're 100% gonna have those just big changeable propane tanks on the outside of the building. Okay, good, I can ride him now. Plants looking nice. Low key little community center, I'm into that. These two thinking they're gangsters. Oh, I have triggered a cutscene somehow. So those other two were from the Blueberry Academy, but they were originally from this town. I guess is what we're getting at here. Yeah, I like that little flowery comfy. Well, not comfy, what's he called? Jingling. Om nom 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 nom. Gochisousa modesta. Okay, the Pikachu tails make it obvious, boy and girl. Those are backwards colors. Right? That is. Whatever, I'm all for ungendered bathrooms. Great. If you're gonna have gendered bathrooms, everyone knows blue is men's, red is women's. And that's not really bringing some Western ass bias. I live in Japan. They follow the same rule. Blue is men's, red is women's. And if I'm bursting for the opposite of thirsting, you know what I mean, and I'm running in here, I'm not checking out like, oh, this is actually the male Pikachu's tail, and this one is the female Pikachu's tail, so I guess I'm in this one. I'm like, no, I'm just running into the blue one, because I need a whiz. Ridiculous. Oh yeah, nice. I had not noticed that. That is funny that there's an in-game talk to a lady to do that. Right, I guess it's bedtime. Oh, I didn't talk to Raya. Oh well. I'm sure I didn't miss, like, the most exciting dialogue in the world. Humanisticism. Oh. I want to offer you promotion of your channel, blah 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 blah. Thanks, but no thanks. I just do this for a bit of a laugh on the side of doing my podcast. And most of my views come on YouTube after the fact anyway, so. It's all good. It's all gravy. The Roto Stick. I didn't read that very well. How am I enjoying it? I'm enjoying the vibes. I'm absolutely loving the vibes. The vibes are exquisite. Very... Like I said, this is basically where I live. I live in Nagano. Very rural Japan. Like where I live is a bit more city, but when I go hiking, it's straight into literally this. And it's captured very, very well. So I'm enjoying that. Oh man. Ah, bummer, but fair enough. Yeah, Pokemon and Animal Crossing are the two awkward ones that don't just... You can't just transfer your slaves the easy way, right? Which I... Slaves. Which I guess is because... You know... They want to avoid cloning Pokemon or selling whatever. It's still a pain in the butt.
Yes.
Oh, man. Yes. Of course I don't mind. I'm going to destroy you. I love bullying children. Let's go. Sentret, nice. Here's my shiniest Bathra. She's a beast. Here, get destroyed by the power of the moon. Thanks, me too. Wow. I also really liked Gen 9 Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. I'm not going to deny they had like their technical hiccups, but it never bothered me at all. And just, yeah, the walking around and really feeling in the world was a great feeling. I probably liked Legends Arceus a little more, because the individual areas had a bit more life to them and felt a bit more real to me. And also, just, you know, as mentioned before, I'm a big weeb for historical rural Japan, so it was very up my street. Yeah. Get frozzed. Wowzers. Wowzers in my trousers. True. Oh, I defeated you both. Oh, that was some side eye. Oh, you lived in Okinawa? Cool. Yeah, it's, well, it seems close, right? But it's not actually. It's not easy to sort of pop over from one to the other. And then even when you visit Japan, right? It's Tokyo, Osaka, etc. I had the advantage. A, when I first came here, I was actually traveling for like 6 months. So I saw a decent amount of rural. And then when I finally found a job, it was here in Nagano. Pure luck of the draw. But I'm actually very grateful. I like the rural vibe. I love the hiking and everything. You've got a little crush on me. Do I need to go to the Pokemon Center? No, it healed me up. Nope. Nope. Okay, down is my camera. Okay, yeah, that's the new thing. That's the selfie stick mode. Eureka. got one hides all the stuff. Oh. Nice. Ooh, Poliwag, cute. Poliwag, whichever one it was. Oh. Oh, it's a Hisuian Growlithe. Oh, this is the photo lady from the trailer. And all the fan art is what I was going to say. my favourite Gen 9 Pokemon is Espathra. That's why I hunted the shiny one to play the DLC with. Similar reason, right? I saw it and I was like, whoa, what is that? That looks crazy. Caught one. And it turned out to be an absolute beast. Similarly, Flamigo. Just caught it. It's like, oh, a Flamigo Pokemon. Nice. A Flamingo Pokemon. Nice. And then once I started using it, it just wrecked house. So yeah, my two little flightless birds carried me through the main game. And I got some shiny ones for the DLC. Wow. Register 150 Pokemon. I can do that. Am I done in town for now? Sure. And probably none streaming for now, as it happens. Well, thank you for watching. I'll be back on Sunday for the usual, not Sunday, not remotely Sunday, my Saturday, most people's Friday, for the usual stream, the old Pokemon stream. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Yeah, just regular monsters that are strong are great. The classic Tauros example, where he was just a big cow, but it absolutely wrecked house for the last two generations. Sorry, I'm replying to chat, which you now can't see because I changed the camera angle. But yep, I will be back. Probably going to mostly just play this on stream. I can't promise I won't play a little bit in my own time, but I've got like Pikmin to be playing, I've got other stuff to be playing, so taking my time with this and just playing it on stream doesn't bother me at all. As long as I can avoid too much spoilerinos. So that's that. I'll catch you in a couple of days, maybe. If you're watching this on YouTube, why not come and watch live? 9 PM BST on a Friday night, which is 5 AM on a Saturday morning for me. So count your blessings, love. Anyway. Peace.